Hey you guys, I'm talking about Scary Famous episode 5. Let me tell y'all before I start this shit, let me tell on myself. I had just was recording this video, right? And I got all the way to the end. I was talking about some shit that was scary or supposed to have been scary. And my light went out and the whole room went black. I was like, bitch, wait, hold on, wait. I'm over here talking about I'm hard. And then the lights went off. Bitch, I punked out. Punked all the way out. Wait. So, okay, let me get to this review. Woo, Lord. Okay. So, Drita in New York, they have to go through this nasty room to find 4 keys. And the first person to find the 4 keys, it unlocks another key to open the door. I thought Drita was going to lose. But like I said, the person that makes better TV end up staying somehow. So, New York wins. Erica happy. Safari happy. But the other part of the house is a little bit on the nervous side because of it's an even kind of playing field now. I think only person that's uneven with them was Sky. But I think Sky is on. It seemed like everybody thinks Sky on their team and she cool. But, nah. Should throw y'all ass under the bus just like I would. Anyway, so then we see a scene where everybody go talk to Drita's grave and say how much of a good cook she is and they gonna miss her. That shit was so funny when New York was talking to her and then was for the pour to drink and was like, not gonna happen. I was like, that would be me. Like, the dead homies can't stick their tongue out and get this. Why do people pour out good stuff for the dead homies that can't taste it? Man, nigga, you're watering the damn dirt. That's all you're doing. So that is what it is. Safari keeps flirting with Erica's getting on my damn nerves. And it's getting on my nerve that he's flirting with her because that's Safari. What's getting on my nerves is Erica's allowing this. And she's supposed to be so cool with Nikki. Nikki used to date Safari. Why do you allow him to do this on camera? I would nip it in the butt and say, look, we homies. It's not going to happen. You see, he ain't trying to push up on Sky because that ain't going to. Sky would cut him off like, boy, go, bye, sit down. But Erica lets him keep doing this so they could both be cool and safe in the house. And I'm like, girl, you a fake ass friend. But whatever. Alaska's mad at Tiffany, talking about she got voodoo and she's tampering with spirits. And now Alaska wants to confront Tiffany. And I'm like, that's not a good idea. I don't think this is a good idea. I think it's stupid. And why would you all of a sudden want to come after Tiffany? Tiffany been talking at spirits and the twins and all kind of other stuff since episode 1. Now, all of a sudden, you want to go after her. To me, it's for camera time. It's for camera time. And I'm just like, whatever, it's not entertaining. Tiffany was like, oh, you picked it up. So now it's like the karma is going to be on Alaska. So now Alaska gets sick. Then she get possessed. Then she's spitting out blood. And everybody, oh my God, scared. Woo, woo, woo. And I'm like, stupid. This is stupid. Bitch, you spitting out blood and you possessed. You got to go. Bitch, no. Producers, we don't play these kind of games. See, that's when black people don't play them type of games like that. But you getting possessed. You can't sleep here tonight. That's for damn sure. Till you go get checked out by the medics, you can't sleep here. That's how we play them kind of games. But okay, we gonna let Alaska act like she possessed and trying to scare the housemates of the house, which I don't think they're scared. I think they're not falling for her games. It's stupid to me. So then we get somebody kidnap Tiffany, and now they got to do the challenge of a fun room, go get Tiffany. And I'm like, only 2 people like her. Why are we going to get her? I would have been like, bitch, leave her where she at. I'm just saying. But it's the challenge, so we're going to go get her out this fun room. Get to the fun room, and I'm like, Sky, I don't play with clowns. I don't like clowns. I'm not scared of clowns, but I do think if a clown run up on me, he might be scared. She might be scared. It's not going to go in their favor. That's all I'm saying. I just hate, like, Sometime. No, I keep saying no because I was like this as a child. I don't play with clowns. I would hit them. But I just be like, I'm too grown for this shit. I'm not running from no clown. I'm not running from nothing in a costume. I'm going to fight you. See, that's why I can't go to haunted houses, Night Scary Farm. You know, stuff with scary shit. You know, Halloween, I don't go in haunted houses when we go trick-or-treating. You jump at me, might be your last jump. I'm just saying, like, you might get stuck. Like, it's stupid to me. So, yeah, them running through that house, I just wanted it to be over. They had 5 minutes, and it seemed like it was way more than 5 minutes, but it seemed like, oh, once we find Tiffany, then it's 23 seconds on the clock. Shut up. So, they going through the thing, running from clowns or whatever. Eva pissed me off when she found Tiffany, but she couldn't get to Tiffany because Tiffany was in another room. She allows herself to tell everybody else, hey, I found her. Tiffany's right here. She's right here. I'm like, dummy, only one of y'all can get the advantage of taking the blindfolds off of her. So why would you tell the other people that you're following? Because Red Man told you. You know, y'all working together, but still be looking out for yourself. So why would you tell everybody else you found her? So while they trying to figure out how to get to the room, Sky ain't even trying. She trying to run from the damn clowns, and she runs into the room with New York, and she takes the blindfold off, and then they have to get out within these couple of seconds. So they get out, and now Sky has the advantage. I would have did the same damn thing Sky did. I'm so sorry. Fuck that, because if you want to break up some alliances, you put two people together, not take it personal and yada, yada, yada. So, I thought that was really cool of her. So, then we have these clowns running to the house, trying to open the door, trying to get in. Some got in. They running through the house. Oh, it was stupid. This is what makes me not care for the show, of the stupidness. Because I'm like, there can be scary moments without us just be like, for real. Really. For real. Like, when Don and... No. Was it Don? No, Safari, and I think it Erica, somebody was sitting there, and that picture just started floating. You kind of be like, yeah, because you're not expecting that. But all them clowns trying to get in, do you know me and my homies would have been sitting there waiting for them to get in? We would have picked up some shit in the house, like, let them in. Let them in. They won't leave the way they came. That's all I'm saying. So I was just like, this is stupid. I was more going back, like, can we go back to the bathroom when Don was in the shower, and while all them running around looking scared for the clowns, I'm just like, put the camera back on Don in the shower. Leave it that part. Just leave it that part. We could hear everybody screaming, but just leave it. I'm telling y'all, I used to love when he was on Top Model. Woo. But yeah, I was just like, this is stupid. Did y'all notice the second time I think they was running from clowns? Eva was like, I'm in a shower. I don't have time for that. I was like, see, that would have been me. Like, this is stupid. Sky, when she came in there to tell the people who was going against each other, she came in there with them fake ass Caesar from Black Ink Crew glasses. And I was just like, girl, would you get to the point? Get to the point. She coming there and trying to ask them why shouldn't she put them up. And I'm sitting there like, I wouldn't even play this game with her. But okay, everybody gonna play this game and say why they want it. I respected Eva. Where she was like, bitch, I told you a million times. I don't care about none of this. I'm just here for my charity. I would respect her. That would have been the only person safe. We all knew New York had immunity, so that was cool. Alaska, she was sick, so I really wouldn't have cared if she would have stayed or gone. But I was with the choice that she made. She put Erica, like, put me up. But you knew you was the obvious choice. That's why. Talking about, so I can keep getting experience. So when it's time to take the head person out, I'm like, okay, cool. But you knew you was going up. That's why you said that. Then she put up Safari because she just wanted to break up the alliance. And I was not mad at her. Could nobody really be mad at her? Safari tried to pop off. And guess what? I laughed the whole time he was popping up to me. They be talking about you. I said, see, this is the type of bitch ass niggas I don't like. Even though I like Safari, he's funny, he good for TV. But in real life, I will punch him in the face. You don't get mad to start telling about everybody else that was talking shit and getting mad because you got put up. Like, boy, if you don't stop, but it is what it is. He act like a little pansy. It is what it is. So, yeah, they got to go up against each other. Like I said, the picture floated in the kitchen. Crazy. Alaska dressed up like a clown and possessed again. I was just like, next week, she needs to go home. She ain't got no immunity. Ain't nobody got time for this stupid stuff. Like I said, black people do not play with being possessed. You got to go. You have to go. I'm telling y'all, you will not be sleeping in the house with me and you possessed or you spitting out shit. You falling all on the floor. You, no. So that's why I say it's for TV time. It's for like a storyline or whatever. And it's stupid though. It's stupid because I'm still like, Alaska, you could have played your strengths way better on this show and in this game of people taking you serious or a drag queen or whatever it is. I just feel like, okay, yes, that's her persona on Drag Race, but it's stupid. It's so stupid. I'm ready to see Erica and Safari go against each other next week. That was so funny because Erica was like, I'm not telling you bitches bye. Y'all don't even want me in the house. Why I'm gonna tell y'all about it? She just walked out to the challenge. And Safari over here being cool with everybody. I'm sitting there like, both of them make the same good TV. So I'm kind of, I wonder who's gonna come back. I'd rather for Safari to come back because he gets more funnier than Erica. But we never know. We always, you know, they always hit us with a little curveball on who comes back. So I'm just ready for next week to see who comes back. Y'all tell me what y'all thought about Scary Famous episode 5. Yes, I will be reviewing the rap game. Me and my daughter have to watch it probably tomorrow, and it'll be up either tomorrow or Sunday, but we will be reviewing the rap game together. My ghetto views are still coming. Black Ink Crew still coming. Yeah, and all that. Follow me on all social media sites by the Ghetto View, T-H-A, not T-H-E, and keep praying for me and my health and my foot and all that good stuff, because I'm really in pain. I just took some medicine to push through this video, but I'll talk to y'all in the next video. All right, peace.